Before we do a couple of word problems, I want to talk about how you can translate a phrase into a mathematical expression. And in this video, we're going to call all of our unknown numbers x. So if we see a phrase like 5 more than a number, we can start with the unknown number x, and to get 5 more than that, we just add 5 to it. So now, no matter what we choose as our x value, this expression, x plus 5, gives us 5 more than that number. For example, back in this phrase, if we chose that number to be 2, then our phrase would read 5 more than 2. Our mathematical expression would then become 2 plus 5, which would give us 7. And I think we can agree that 5 more than 2 is the same thing as 7. Let's say our phrase instead is a number increased by 14. Again, our unknown number we're going to call x, and to increase that by 14, we also add 14. If our phrase was 4 less than a number, then we would start with that unknown number x and subtract 4 from it. If our phrase was a number decreased by 3, we would start with that number and we would decrease it by 3 by subtracting 3. If our phrase was twice a number, the word twice also means double. And if we take twice a number, that means 2 times that number. So that expression would be 2 times x. The expression 6 times a number would be written as x times 6, or 6x. If our phrase is 9 decreased by a number, then our expression should start with that 9, and then if we're decreasing it by an unknown number, we will subtract x from it. If we have the phrase the difference between a number and 13, the difference between that number and 13 would be x minus 13. Now we can start to make these a little bit more complicated by combining some of these concepts above. For example, 4 less than 3 times a number. We could refer back to this example up here where we said 4 less than a number is x minus 4. But if we want 4 less than 3 times a number, then we should really be subtracting 4 from 3x. Another example, 10 more than twice a number. 10 more than suggests that we should be adding 10 to something. This expression would represent 10 more than a number, but if we want 10 more than twice a number, we need to multiply that unknown by 2. The sum of 5 times a number and 7 suggests that we're going to add two things together because we use the word sum. 5 times a number is 5x and 7. And I have one more for you right here. 8 times a number decreased by 3. We're going to take 8 times x, and we're going to decrease that by 3 by subtracting 3. Now, each of these phrases became a mathematical expression, but sometimes phrases can become mathematical equations. The way that we can see at first glance that each of these phrases is going to become an equation rather than an expression is the existence of this word is in each one of these phrases. In each phrase, the word is going to represent an equal sign in our equation. So, for example, 6 more than a number is 10. 6 more than a number. So we can start with a number and add 6 to it, and we're going to say that is 10, so we're going to set that equal to 10. Now we have a mathematical equation that we could solve for x. For our next phrase, we have 5 less than a number is 20. So 5 less than a number, that means we're going to start with a number, we're going to subtract 5, and we're going to say that is 20, so that equals 20. Again, we could use our skills with equation solving to solve that for x. But let's move on to the next one. We have twice a number decreased by 6 is 12. Well, twice a number is the same thing as double a number. We can call that 2x. We're going to decrease that by 6, and we're going to say that is 12, so that equals 12. Next, a number decreased by 13 is 6 times the number. So now we're seeing the word number on either side of the equal sign. Let's try it out. We have a number decreased by 13, that's x minus 13, is, and then we have 6 times the number. Well, 6 times a number is 6x. Let's try one more. A number increased by 6 is 3 less than twice the number. A number increased by 6, we can say is x plus 6. Is our equal sign. 3 less than twice the number is going to be 2x minus 3. We started with twice the number. 3 less than that would mean subtracting 3. Now let's look at just a couple of word problems. When traveling for work, Jana is reimbursed $140 per night for lodging and 70 cents per mile traveled. How many miles did Jana travel if she was reimbursed $315 for a one-night trip? Now you're going to see a lot of advice for how to solve word problems. Read the problem carefully, read it more than once, draw a sketch. I think the most important piece of advice is to figure out what it is we're actually trying to solve for, and then naming that some variable. So in this example, it's asking how many miles did Jana travel? So we need to call that something. I'm going to call it x. And x is going to be the number of miles that Jana traveled. If we don't do this step, then it's just going to be really hard to make an equation out of this problem.
But let's see, now that we've defined our variable, we can start to put an equation together. This says that Jaina was reimbursed $315, and that amount of money is made up of one night of reimbursement for $140, plus whatever money Jaina got for traveling, 70 cents per mile. So if Jaina traveled 1 mile, she gets 70 cents. If Jaina traveled 10 miles, she gets $7. If Jaina travels 100 miles, she gets $70. The way I'm getting each of these numbers is I'm taking 0.7, or 70 cents, and I'm multiplying it by how many miles Jaina traveled. Well, how many miles did Jaina travel? We don't know yet. That's our unknown that we called x. So far, this equation says that Jaina was reimbursed $140 for one night of lodging, plus she was reimbursed 70 cents per mile. And all of that reimbursement needs to add up to $315. We now have an equation that we can solve. To start isolating x, the first step would be to subtract 140 from both sides of the equation. On the left side, we're left with 315 minus 140, which is 175. On the right side, we're left with 140 minus 140. Those cancel, which was kind of the idea. So we just have 0.7x left over. Now you'll notice that x is being multiplied by 0.7. To get x by itself, then we're going to have to divide both sides of the equation by 0.7. Doing that division on the left gives us 250, and on the right, the 0.7s cancel, leaving us with x by itself, and that is our answer. And you might be wondering, well, what is that x? Well, that's what we defined in the first place. That is the number of miles that Jaina traveled. And as always, it's good to check your answer. At least make sure that this amount of miles makes sense. I would be thinking, okay, that 70 cents per mile times 250 miles, that would mean Jaina earned $175 in mileage. Add that to the 140, that'll give us that 315. Okay, so just a really quick check. So I think that that answer is right, and we can move on to the last problem. A rectangular deck needs to be 2 feet longer than it is wide. What are the dimensions of the deck if the perimeter is to be 64 feet? So here's a rectangular deck, and we can say that this is a width and this is the length. And ultimately, these are the two variables that we're looking for. So W is our width, L is our length. But problems aren't as easy to do if we have two variables. Let's try to keep this to one variable. So let's use the fact that we know that this deck needs to be 2 feet longer than it is wide. What that means is, however long this width W is, this side needs to be 2 feet longer than that W. So if this side is W, this side is going to be W plus 2. And because this is a rectangle, this side over here is going to be W plus 2, and this side over here is going to be W. Now, as far as an equation goes, we know that the perimeter of this deck needs to be 64 feet. So the perimeter needs to be 64. And the word perimeter means the length all the way around the deck. And the length all the way around the deck is this W plus 2 plus this W plus this W plus 2. Now, we have an equation here with a bunch of like terms. We have 4 W's that can all be combined into 4 W, and we have this 2 plus this 2, which can be combined to make 4. Now, we have ourselves an equation to solve, which we can start by subtracting 4 from both sides. On the left, that gives us 60. On the right, the 4's cancel, which was the idea, and we get 4W. Now, we need to find that W, but it is being multiplied by 4, so to get rid of that, we need to divide by 4. On the left side, we need to do 60 divided by 4, which turns out to be 15. And on the right side, the 4's cancel, and we're just left with W. So this equation right here tells us that the width of our deck is 15 feet. If we need the length of the deck, well, we know that that is W plus 2. So we can add 2 to that 15 to get 17 feet as our length. Okay, I hope that video gets you started on word problems. I'll see you in the next one.